In a sport celebrated for its intensity, some moments stand out for all the wrong reasons. Join us as we delve into the realm of hockey's dirtiest hits of all time, where fines and suspensions couldn't stop these players from leaving a lasting mark on the game. From the era of aggressive, hard-hitting hockey to the present, where player safety is a top priority, there are still some players who push the limits and play with unmatched intensity. Let's take a look at these players. 1993, Dale Hunter on Pierre Turgeon. Dale Hunter's infamous late hit on Pierre Turgeon is often viewed through the lens of frustration rather than deliberate intent to injure. In the 1993 playoffs, Pierre Turgeon's crucial goal for the Islanders against Hunter's Capitals led to a moment of humiliation for Hunter, who responded with a rash and violent act. In a fit of frustration, Hunter blindsided Turgeon and forcefully thrust him into the wall, causing significant head and shoulder injuries to the victim. This egregious violation of sportsmanship and player safety did not go unpunished. Hunter's actions resulted in an unprecedented 21-game suspension. 1998. Craig Ludwig on Timo Salan of the Anaheim Ducks managed to outmaneuver Craig Ludwig of the Dallas Stars along the boards, making a swift move behind the cage. However, just as Salan seemed to have gained the upper hand, Ludwig, the Dallas defenseman, caught up to him with a forceful hit. Ludwig left his feet and his elbow connected with Salan's head, sending the Celestial Anaheim forward, crashing into the glass. The impact was jarring, and Salan's health was immediately called into question as he fell to the ice. Fortunately, despite the severity of the hit, Salan remarkably missed no games following the incident. 2000, Scott Stevens on Eric Lindros. The concerns surrounding this hit stemmed entirely from Eric Lindros' extensive history of concussions leading up to the incident. Lindros had already endured 5 previous concussions, including 3 within the calendar year of 2000 alone. The hit he suffered from Stevens during Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals marked his 4th concussion in just 5 months and his 2nd in 23 days. This alarming pattern of head injuries raised serious concerns about Lindros' health and safety on the ice. Following the hit, Lindros was sidelined for a staggering 16 months before eventually joining the New York Rangers and returning to play on October 5, 2001. 2001, Taiadomi on Scott Niedermayer. When Taiadomi delivered a devastating elbow to the New Jersey Devils defenseman in the final moments of Game 4 of the Eastern Conference semifinals, the consequences were swift and severe. Domi was promptly banned for the remainder of the postseason as a result of his actions. However, despite the initial concerns, Niedermayer displayed remarkable resilience and was able to make a surprisingly swift recovery. Within a mere 12 days, he was back on the ice, playing in the final 11 playoff games for New Jersey, en route to a championship loss to Colorado. 2003, Scott Stevens on Paul Kariya. ABC analyst John Davidson was quick to emphasize the persistent threat of concussions looming over Paul Kariya. Drawing a parallel to Eric Lindros' experience 3 years earlier, Davidson highlighted how Scott Stevens had delivered a devastating hit to one of the league's most injury-prone stars during a crucial playoff game, specifically in the second period of Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final. In the tense moments following the hit, fear gripped fans and commentators alike as they awaited news of Kariya's condition. However, their apprehension soon turned to sheer astonishment when Kariya defied the odds and made a remarkable return to the bench and then to the ice. In a true display of resilience and skill, Kariya not only re-entered the game, but also managed to score a sensational goal, a moment that would be etched into highlight reels for years to come. 2007, Steve Downey on Dean McCammond. Rarely do charging infractions involve the perpetrator's skates being as elevated off the ice as Steve Downey's were when he forcefully lunged into Dean McCammond during a preseason game. The severity of the hit resulted in significant repercussions for both players, as Downey faced a suspension while McCammon sustained a debilitating injury. Former NHL disciplinarian Colin Campbell aptly captured the severity of the incident when announcing Downey's 20-game suspension, stating, "It's a hit that as soon as you see it live, you think, this is going to be a bad one." Campbell's words resonated with fans and commentators alike, highlighting the visceral reaction evoked by the egregious nature of the hit and the ensuing consequences for both players involved. 2015, Rafi Torres on Jakob Silfverberg. Even within Torres's laundry list of offenses, this particular hit from 2015 stands out as one of the dirtiest, both from an objective and subjective standpoint. It resulted in one of the longest suspensions in NHL history, totaling 41 games. During a preseason matchup while playing for the Sharks, Torres delivered a brutal check on Anaheim Ducks' Jakob Silfverberg. What made this hit particularly egregious was the context surrounding it. Torres was far removed from the play at the time, taking several long strides before making contact. The primary point of contact was Silfverberg's head, clearly indicated by Torres leaving the ice and elevating his shoulder to initiate the check. Adding to the severity of the hit, it occurred a mere 0.8 seconds after Silfverberg had lost possession of the puck. 2007, Randy Jones on Patrice Bergeron, NESN's Gord Kluzak, WBZ's Dave Gusher and Bob Beers, and the Boston Globe's Fluto Shinzawa all recalled the heartbreaking story of former Boston University player Travis Roy when the incident occurred during the first month of the 2007-08 season. The hit had devastating consequences for Patrice Bergeron, sidelining him for the remainder of the season. In the years that followed, Bergeron experienced several aftershock concussions, further complicating his recovery journey. Despite the challenges he faced, Bergeron displayed remarkable resilience and determination. Over time, he gradually regained his pre-injury form and continued to excel on the ice. His perseverance paid off when he scored the clinching goal during the Bruins' triumphant Stanley Cup victory in 2011. Additionally, Bergeron added a prestigious Olympic gold medal to his trophy case in 2010. His remarkable comeback story continues to inspire fans and fellow athletes alike. 2000, Marty McSorley on Donald Brashear. During his time with the Canucks, Brashear became the victim of a notorious incident in hockey history. After a previous altercation where Brashear injured Bruins goalie Byron Defoe, McSorley sought retribution. Despite multiple attempts to provoke Brashear into a fight, he refused to engage. McSorley's frustration peaked when Brashear taunted the Bruins by flexing his muscles near their bench. In the waning moments of the game, McSorley delivered a two-handed blow to Brashear's head with his stick, causing him to fall unconscious and suffer a grade 3 concussion along with an on-ice seizure. McSorley was immediately ejected from the game and received an indefinite suspension from the NHL. Additionally, he was charged with assault with a weapon by a British Columbia court but avoided jail time. McSorley served only 23 games of his year-long suspension before retiring from professional hockey. 2004, Todd Bertuzzi on Steve Moore became a marked man from the start of the game on March 8, 2004. With players like May delivering hard hits. However, Todd Bertuzzi took it to the extreme. As the play moved up ice, Bertuzzi blindsided Moore with a sucker punch to the neck, causing both to collapse onto the ice amidst a growing pileup. Moore was stretchered off the ice after lying motionless for 10 minutes, never to return to professional hockey. Bertuzzi received a match penalty and was suspended indefinitely as per NHL protocol. This incident sparked a lengthy legal battle, spanning courts in the US and Canada. Moore and his family sought significant damages, arguing that his NHL career was unfairly ended during his rookie season. After years of legal proceedings, an out-of-court settlement was reached in August 2014. The settlement, reportedly worth $22 million, included contributions from the NHL, Bertuzzi, the Canucks, and part owner John McCaw. This was our list of dirtiest hits in NHL history. If you have any hits in mind, do let us know in the comments for part 2, like this video, and subscribe to our channel to support us.